Will for Sound on Sound at ProLight and Sound with Alex from Audio Technica, who's going to show us the 5047, which is a new microphone in the 50 series. It has these four rectangular diaphragms to make the whole capsule, and there's something a bit different about the 47 than there is about the 5040, for instance, isn't there?
Yes, certainly. Why, the 5040, which looks from the outside almost the same as the 5047, just a different color. As you said, the same elements inside. Is directly bringing out the signal to the output. The situation with the 5040 is it's kind of a diva. So it delivers a very high output level at a very distinct low impedance. So if your input stage on the console is not good enough to handle this lady, you have a problem that at high sound pressure level, you're actually draining too much current out of the microphone, which will reduce the audio quality in your input stage. It's not the fault of the microphone, it's just the microphone input not necessarily good enough. Mm-hmm. Now to solve this, for those users who don't afford a very expensive mic input, we came up with the 5047 design, which we have split naked here behind us, which the most obvious part is the transformer output coupler, as you say. Now the transformer is actually taking care of that. We lower the sensitivity with it, so the signal is somewhat lower than the 5040. At the same time, the impedance is very stable and significantly higher. So the input stage doesn't need to take care about anything. So the microphone takes care of that. This. Now on the other side, for the tonality, that means the transformer coupled output is always having a kind of a saturation effect, especially in the low frequency, so it sounds a little bit more warmer. Mm-hmm. So tonality-wise, they're not the same. Although the diaphragm is exactly identical, they sound actually different. While the 5040 is really pure, it's exactly what you think. There's no resonance whatsoever, there's no distortion, there's no saturation effect, almost no noise. It's the lowest self-noise that we ever made, and I think it's one of the lowest in the world. This is different than the 5047. The noise is a little bit higher, but not much. It's like still a very good 6 dB or something, which is extraordinarily good. But it has a different tonality. It's not as pure as the 5040 anymore. But it has this warm touch on it, which people actually like. So we have a fan base for both types of tonality in there. One nice side effect with the transformer coupler, though, is we increased the max SPL significantly. So the overall dynamic range is the largest that we could achieve. So we're targeting 142 dB dynamic range.
Wow, that's
which
impressive.
Is outstanding. So whether it's a butterfly taking off or a nuclear explosion, yeah, you're in with that one. It can do this all at the same
right.
time.
Okay, and can you tell us about the transformer itself?
It's a handmade transformer. We tried some off-the-shelf items like Lundahl transformers, which are supposedly the best ones. They are all pretty good, don't get me wrong. They don't match exactly our needs, what we had with our impedance. So we were actually trying, and just like, okay, one more twist. And we made a total of over 40 different transformers, always just like one more. And then we picked the one which fitted exactly what we wanted to have. So they are all handmade in Japan, as the entire microphone is. So there's nothing, it's part of the deal actually, because making this diaphragm as a rectangular is a hell of a job. If I make my bed at home, in the corners I always have wrinkles. Like, in there should be no wrinkles in the corner. And controlling the tension is actually the manufacturing secret of that microphone.
And just for people who maybe don't know the 5040 so well, the reasoning for going for a rectangular diaphragm rather than a traditional circular
is
what?
If you think about it, the traditional way would be round. Now, a round diaphragm is very simple to make. You know, you just glue it on or you screw it in and it's fine. But it has one distinct diameter, which is representing a string on a guitar, if you like. So it has a resonance frequency.
Sure.
Now, a rectangular, if you would think about it, has two. Well, that's actually not the case for our solution, because we change the tension on every virtual line that we have horizontally and vertically. So we have a kind of an infinitive amount of different resonance frequency, and hence at the same time, none at all. Because they are all so little that they don't participate for anything. So in the waterfall diagram, so if you take the frequency response over time, on a standard microphone, you have like lines coming out. Resonance frequencies, which do not exist on this design. That's one of the reasons why we use rectangular. And why four of them? If you think about it, the bigger the diaphragm, the better the signal-to-noise ratio, which is kind of like what you like to have. But at the same time, the mass gets very high. So the transient response, the speed, the velocity, how quick the thing starts to shrink, goes slower. Mm-hmm. So you don't like that. So if you take four little ones, they are fast. So you have the transient response with a high frequency and everything, which is making the attack of a sound so nice on an instrument. Mm-hmm. While at the same time, you add up to a large surface to bring the noise floor down.
Right.
Of course, it comes with the cost. You buy four microphones, basically. Mm. Well, one sidekick is balancing, which is either done with an operation amplifier, which adds in noise, or a transformer, which adds in saturation effects. Mm. On the 5040, we don't do any of these. We take just two elements and say these are plus, and the other two, they are minus. So actually, we have to match these elements. So matched pairs, that was yesterday. We do a match set of four within a ratio of 0.2 dB tolerance. That's a real matched microphone.
Right, so how much will the new one cost then, and when will that be available?
Availability should be sometime in summer. Mm-hmm. We're just in the final testing of the production line that we have set up so that everybody is trained properly. That's happening right now while we're talking. Mm-hmm. So we expect the first mass production shipment to arrive. Mass production sounds big. We're not talking thousands here. When it comes to price point, in the UK we target £3,499, mm-hmm. including a VHA retail price. In Europe, continental, it will be £3,999.
Okay, fantastic. Thanks very much, Alex.
You're welcome, sir. Thank you.